I'm Pat Gunn, and this is part of my Let's Play series for Fallout 4. So you'll see, I'm here at the Nuka World Red Rocket, and I've turned it into a settlement. Here we can see that we have a nice outhouse out on the edge of town. Actually, it's more of a full bathroom. Unfortunately, so you can get nicer versions of the sinks and toilets, but they're still just the generic bathtub. I'm sure that there are mods that can fix that, but I tend not to use mods. You can see that I've enclosed the filling area of the station with a jump fence, and I've built a defense structure, which I'm suddenly realizing needs a little bit of touching up. Something like this. Well, it's probably this looks like it's the right match. Okay. And now we just need a little bit of additional stairs. I had never seen it from that angle. Sorry, this is not. Okay, so we have a defense structure, which is just a set of stairs. How we're going to it. And a rocket launcher and a laser. Rocket launcher is aimed over there where, inexplicably, I think it's probably a bug due to the limits of how much of the land is preserved in settlements. I think it's just outside, which means that it has a good chance of respawning foes every time you travel out of the cell. Just a theory, don't know for sure. There is my central fusion generator, and you can see that I have defense systems set up all over the place. But I've blocked off entrance into the central area. I have some nice farms over here. Scavenging station, trash bin, yada yada. I don't yet have the ability to build trader stands. When I do, I'll probably put some in this grass island in the middle of the road. But I have my water plant out here. Maybe I shouldn't. And so first, let's take a look at what we have in here. We have the start of what's going to be the trading area. So this is meant to be an area where it's just safe for settlers to congregate. I might set up a bar somewhere. But it's very handy to have somebody to sell the junk to from the frequent battles up the hill. And then over here, we have a bit of a work area. I think this was here originally. I added a weapons plant, and we have stairs up here, leading to a little bit of a resting area, and then this is where our usual bed is. So cool. That's a few beds. It's not everything we have. Oh, and we have a defense area here, because I don't remember where the spawn points are for attacks on this
farm's settlement. Not much, but it's some
huts. I want to have somebody watching the front. Also, it kind of makes sense that if that door is the main entrance into the settlement, apart from the gate, I want to have somebody watching it. And here we have railway cars for a little bit more of a place for people to sleep. And you can see I always set up shelves for people to keep their belongings, their clothes, stuff like that. I don't typically go through the bother of placing them, but I want it to be plausible to the extent that I can imagine this being a decent place to live. Wow, that is a steep grade for a highway. Interesting. Anyhow, this is our settlement out here. If you remember where we left off with the last video, we were starting to do quests for the railroad, so let's head back and get on to doing that. We have an active quest. we're taking Deacon with us, because I don't quite remember what perk you get from Deacon, but Deacon is a companion who...
What was that?
...is not going to be...
Now that's just the noise.
That travel really landed us.
Go ahead, run. The trick is being hidden. I'm not letting this happen.
Oh, shoot, that little... Well, it's a good thing.
So that was an industry.
Tactical weapons around. Anyway, that's not our fight right now. We're gonna run out. So, we've been asked to retrieve things from the building. There's Stockton's hollow tape, and we need to go and meet Stockton. Actually, maybe I'll go out.
Fighting again.
Yeah, definitely not the brightest thing that fellow's ever done, but then again, I suppose it probably works for most people passing by. They just have no understanding of who they're dealing with here. And it looks like our quest marker here is taking us. Right. This is a settlement for...
Do it!
Suggesting the fastest linear route to the warehouse, but this is and I think it's just going by distance, it's not holding times, but you should think about holding times. This is taking us to... so much for a dramatic reveal. I don't quite know... Yeah, this is probably where the quest marker is. Bunker Hill. Settlement
you
which
there.
I had not discovered before.
Caravan or raider?
I'm here on my own.
Freelance, huh? All right. Come on in.
Okay. So...
Market's the white building with all the fancy columns. Always someone doing trading there. Kay can patch you up if you're hurt. Best doc and vet around.
So, that raises an interesting point. Ordinarily, you would kind of expect vets and doctors to be kind of the same profession. If they're doing at least things that on their surface...
Welcome, my friend. Might I ask, do you have a Geiger counter?
Mine is in the shop.
You? I was... Uh-huh. You're with our...
Yeah, I'm with the railroad.
Perhaps you should lower your voice.
Sure.
You've just joined, haven't you?
Mm-hmm.
So maintaining...
A trader always has to move his merch.
Exactly. My current... I'm supposed to...
Facilitate delivery.
It's scheduled...
Uh-huh.
We need to have a conversation.
You've got my attention.
I'm always looking... From what I hear...
I live for danger.
I like your by the way, but you'll need to talk. Come down to Cat.
Secure the delivery site. Then we'll join you.
So that was interesting. Apparently, Yeah, we have never bumped into that guy before, and it started out with that questline, which is kind of a handy questline to do eventually. But we'll hold off on that quest until later. For now, we're asked to secure a rendezvous point. I think this is a fast travel that'll take us right into combat again, but we'll deal with it. So again, as I was saying, vets and doctors, they perform things. Their jobs are very similar, and I always was a little surprised that they're not trained mostly the same way. I mean, I suppose with humans, you're dealing with a much more narrow...
Seems we have...
You're dealing with a much more narrow scope of biological variation because it's one species. Whereas vets, I suspect usually they're not so so specialized. Maybe I'm wrong on that. Maybe there are vets that specialize in dogs or cats or horses, things like that. But I'm not sure if that's the only difference. I understand that they're both well-paid, difficult professions. Probably fairly similar emotional consequences for not getting something quite right.
What?
Okay, so we need to clear this place out from radar influence.
Nothing there now. What do you think?
Hey!
You're in shit.
Don't mean to make you nervous, but...
And yeah. Again, arcing weapons, awesome. And there is old man Stockman and his friend.
Everything looks clear. This is H-222. H-2, here's the person I talked to you about.
Nice to meet you.
Another person, actually.
Remember what I...
Uh-huh.
I'll fire up. And... there. Time for me to go. Keep H-2 safe. Someone will be here shortly.
Okay, so, cleared out the raiders. Just a few shots. Now we're waiting for somebody to meet with us. And there's another somebody.
Easy there.
Don't shoot, Professor, right? And my man Deacon. Still with the same old face? What? It's been three whole...
Right.
I keep meaning to go to the face doctor. I heard about you. Walk the freedom trail.
Do you have a Geiger counter?
Right you are. Mine is in the shop. All good? Now.
Sure.
Hey, you okay?
A little rattled, but...
He told you right, H2. Oh, listen. There's more than raiders.
Uh-huh. More raiders?
You headquarter have... We need to get to... A lot of sense, fresh off.
All right. Ticonderoga.
I'll lead the way.
Okay, so we just need to be an escort. I'm switching off the arcing weapon because I'm worried that it might end up hitting one of these two, and I would prefer it not do that. So it might turn the railroad hostile. At the very least, I suspect it would fail the quest. Or at least, it might kill them, and that would probably fail the quest. I'm not sure if they're marked essential. But even if they are, they might notice being hit and become hostile.
Who's that?
Don't you die at me!
Hell yeah.
Anything interesting on him?
These freighters don't seem to be leveled. So... Yeah. Cool. If they were level to our level, we'd have to worry.
Hey, high-rise.
We can catch up at Tycon. We just gotta make it there alive first.
Oh, I think we were scheduled to walk by here, but we had already wiped them out. You have to be careful with that a lot, in at least a few places in this game. In that... if you do some things in the wrong order, you can screw up the quests, and they won't trigger. And you'll be locked out of progressing at a certain point. The game has gotten a little bit better on that, although it's really easy to do it with some of the introductory Brotherhood of Steel stuff. Although I think we already went along those quest lines. So we don't need to worry about that in particular. I think this is our destination. Maybe.
Hi, Raz.
And we're here. All in a night's work for you agent types. Huh.
I'm not here.
That's the point, then. If you ever need grub and Deacon, Deacon may be a terrible...
Okay. So, we've completed that quest. And we'll return to Railroad HQ.
Tom wants you for something.
We've got a lot of synths in play right now. It makes things really dangerous.
Analyzing.
Pam.
Solving for theta n when I approaches probability bounds. Commencing recurrence analysis using Dabrovian
methods. You want to keep on talking to everybody?
Boy's been working on it. Tiny little packet.
For side, hell of a big kid.
Is it safe?
You say safe? Yeah, man. I mean, well.
Excuse me.
Dez has given me clearance to set up my atmospheric sensors. Finally!
Give me details.
So my sensor, I call it, chuck that stuff if you need to.
Tell me where to...
I got the perfect... Whoa! Terry? Where's Terry? Oh, yeah. Too much nitroglycerin. Back to the drawing board.
Carrington.
Heavy's bloody traipsing around at all hours. I take it the H-222 situation has been... But there's yet more to be done.
Sure.
Since the fall of the switchboard...
I'll get it done.
Details await at the deck.
Okay, so I don't know exactly which quests lead to the type of armor.
Up there, assume you're being watched.
Improvements that we need, always. So we're just going to do all of them.
Pam.
Confirmed. Agent Professor has arrived. I have a mission without increasing solution.
I get to set up.
Agent's temperature. Pacify the target.
Okay, so. Yeah, we're just going to keep on doing all of these quests until the option opens up to build the armor that
one
we need.
More hour till my shift ends.
Now, I think there might be one more person that we can talk to get these quests.
Sorry, Tinker Tom's got me doing...
Maybe
something.
Glory?
The importance of Bunker Hill and our asset there is not widely known. Please keep it that way.
Sure where Glory is. She might not be in the base right now. But I know that there's a third quest line that you can do. Okay, so Coastal Cottage sounds pretty useful. We also haven't cleared out Kingsport Lighthouse. Or the Slog. Well, let's start with the Slog and then work our way eastward. Since one of the things that you often want to do in Fallout is to make all your trips count against more than one of your objectives. It's a kind of useful efficiency you also probably should try and do in life.
Come on in. The water's deadly.
Oh, they actually all are in the water. Except for this guy.
Welcome to the slog. We're the only target.
Uh-huh. It's pretty clever.
I appreciate your... When I came across, you probably noticed. I used to live in Dunn. I decided that...
It looks like you've done...
It's a good start. What if this place could... What if it could...
Sure.
We want this to be... Maybe we can make...
I think it's a great idea.
You really think so?
We can't sell Tarbert. There's a gang of super... It'd be a great hope.
I'll take care of those super mutants.
Good. I didn't know what we were going to do.
Okay. So that's one quest. Breakheart Banks is just over there. We'll accept it. And now we're gonna... Maybe head west and take care
of Breakheart.
It
might be safe.
Ooh, you grow the best tarberries in the Commonwealth.
And then we'll head northeast and continue our quest line. And so I feel a little bit like this is making...
They were just here, damn it.
About why people clear out animals from areas. Which seems unfortunate.
Hey, you're compromised. Engaging.
Assaultron. Not good.
Was just for the experience of the loot, really. But it's not Scott like that. Okay, so somewhere up here we have what looks like maybe a raider settlement, although it does have lots of human skulls. Okay, break hard tanks. Oh, right, this is actually a super mutant base. So let's see if we can cook them out. In some combat. Let's see.
Whoa, everybody stop!
Oh, you are wrong. There you go. Very nice. Very nice indeed.
Well, howdy.
This ledge is quite good weaponry for a super mutant. Let's take our level up. What are we gonna do? One thing I have not had is the ability to build the nicer types of stores. Unfortunately, I have to spend 2 whole levels on that, and I might just not want to do that initially. Let's keep on bumping up our life, because the additional damage just matters that much. And let's save just in case, because I don't like needing to re-level.
Here I was wanting to spend the day reading Proust, and then you had to ruin it.
So Deacon, unfortunately, he's one of my favorite companions, but he's affiliated with a faction that I just... facing Super Mutant Primus.
You know, running away is always an option.
Lost him. So that's how it feels.
There you are.
That is a legendary opening. Sweet Jesus, that is... not gonna be a fun photo.
Now this is a workout.
Since it means, because they're using weapons, the higher status just means that they have a whole lot more health than we really would want them to. Let's see if we can damage his head. Just this one foe. You can see that this is a former settlement. And probably a pretty good one. Probably is lacking a little bit in defense. But honestly,
we made that look easy.
If these guys are coming after you, then probably even the very best of weapons is not going to really be all that. Maybe we should break these things down. A lot of steel and some screws. That's kind of useful. Whole lot of good stuff. Can't break this down, unfortunately. But no, that's at least something. And we get... very nice. Okay. So we took care of that. We'll pop by this, back by the slog. The downside of the slog is that they produce a lot of food, and that means they frequently face some pretty severe attacks. But you'd better build defense once you take responsibility.
Well, you're still alive. That either means you haven't gone after those super mutants yet, or good news.
Come on in! The water's deadly!
Those super mutants won't be bothering you again.
I guess you are the right person for the job, huh? Thanks, friend. By the way, feel free to use our workshop. I'm glad to count you as a friend.
Okay.
I'd like to trade some items.
Okay.
So we're gonna hand him the revolutionary sword. Because we're not gonna use it. And we'll have to make a note that the next time we're at the Mechanist Lair, we'll want to connect the slog to our We'll want to connect this log to our trade network so that we'll have the materials we need to build them some defense. Because right now, even if we wanted to, not a whole lot we can do for them. I might just go and take over that settlement a little bit later. Let's just take care of our quest right now. It's a little bit northeast. We can at least see that there's something there on our map. See our weapons reloaded. Oh, goodness. So there's a lake, and some radiation dumped in it, and some blood bugs in there. I don't really like fighting those guys. Let's skip it. Sounds like Deacon might have preferred not to just skip it. And we're coming up. There are some raiders. We need to clear them from this area.
Looks like
maybe we can see how much the Mirabucks want to do. In general, if you have two of your foes fighting each other, you can either take advantage of the confusion, go on and get some good hits, or you can see if they'll finish each other off for you. Either works. Mix and match those strategies. I'm not quite sure how we've been spotted or why. Looks like the raider took
Where'd
care of
that little bitch go? Made a big mistake with me.
Okay, that's then another useful or useless. Sweet. And we are asked to build defenses. It sounds like there might still be foes around here. Maybe up the hill a little bit.
This is the part where you're supposed to die.
Let's see. Oh. Deacon brought you. Giant mess of different foes, not mess of giant different foes. So let's store our junk. And we need to somehow build some initial defenses. And that means clearing this place up. I need the seat. The coat rack. Leave the door alone. Sure if you're meant to clear enough out of here to be able to build the defenses with what's already here, or if you're meant to run back to your other settlements to get stuff. Okay, let's see what we can do. Yeah, we can at least build one turret. It can be an advanced turret. Perfect, but it's at least something. Now, where shall we build it? We would like to build it in a place where I think the normal spawn point for foes is they run up the hill at you. This is not a functional bad. It's not a bad thing to clear it out. Clear out these boxes. Let's try putting it here. Not perfect, but again, a few things in life need to be as if they can be. Okay, so that's one turret. This is interesting. It looks like this truck was driving through the house. Doesn't make sense. Why would that be? Here that I don't quite understand. That really doesn't make sense that the truck would be driving right through the middle of the house, unless maybe in the confusion right after or during or right after the apocalypse, a driver lost control, drove through the house, and house collapsed, and the cellar collapsed. Anyhow, we don't have enough gear or oil to finish building this, but that's okay. I will just pop back to one of my settlements to pick some up. Let's first see. Nope, that's a steal. No gear or oil there. It would have been nice if they had given you what you need right in this area, but...
You might want to focus on the valuable salvage. Surely you'll break your back carrying worthless scrap.
Yeah, so that provided the gear. We're just shy on oil now. I don't want to spend the whole time here figuring out how to get some oil. Let's just head back home and pick some up. Junk that you end up picking up out here. My character is still way up there in terms of the weight. I'm not sure what I picked up that pushed me. Maybe a lot of it is this meat. Uh, 144, that's still much higher than I would like, but it also be some of these frag grenades. Anyhow. What we're looking for is oil. some flip lighters will do, I guess. Once we have this place hooked up, anything that we leave there will be part of our trade network anyhow, so it doesn't really matter too much. Get some springs. Maybe I can see if this will let me build more of build one of the nicer ones. I didn't really pay a lot of attention. Okay. Off we go. We will swing by the mechanist and hook the slog up to our trade, or hook green top and slog up to our trade network. Takes us nicely down in weight. Let's see. Head to the dead drop.
This doesn't look right. Not right at all.
Bears.
I'm ready to go.
We team up with a mortuary. You see where I'm going with this, right?
A report.
Augusta is still dark. Location enclosed. Exercise extreme caution.
Okay, so that doesn't sound good. Sounds pretty worried. So, I Augusta Safe House is near the Kendall Hospital. Now, that location seems like a really bad spot for
time to earn our paycheck.
I'm getting paid, right?
Seems like a really bad place for a dead drop. Well, maybe I'm wrong, because the plus to it would be that very few people would stumble across the message, very few people would go there, but it does mean that people would need to sneak into a highly dangerous place with bears. So in one sense it would be great, in another sense it'd be terrible, and we're getting experience. I'm not sure why. Actually, I think I might have an idea why. Sometimes the game likes to spice up some areas by spawning some crows in there.
Low on supply. Need to take more risks. Caravans ain't that well guarded.
Okay. Felt has one F-E-L-T, F-E-L-T, all is plausible. Nope. F-E-L-T, B-A-L-L. This is also possible.
Nice.
Yep. Except we opened a useless door because it's too busy to make it through. I heard some raiders who are unhappy with the supplies. And we can kind of hear a clapping sound.
Nothing there now.
Of turrets. We've got to be careful.
Got it.
A body burning in there, which is funny.
I don't know.
But not a bad way to deal with corpses.
You're probably right. You gotta cut down on the jet, I guess.
I don't start talking crazy.
Oh, more bodies. Yeah, so
spread out! Find him!
It's fighting time. You know, you're really good at this. Too good.
I got him!
You know, ammo isn't cheap. Can we just pay you to play dead?
Shook up like sense we're here.
Anything interesting on him?
More not super useful, legendary.
We got come on, time, girl!
Game seems to have... Now that's kind of interesting that they would refer to you that way, because they probably haven't had a good look at you.
You always got away.
I'm not sure how they would know that they have.
Aww, too bad for you.
Got me. You know, running away is always an option. I won't shoot. I promise.
Seven open new books. It's kind of funny.
Now this, this is a workout.
Okay, so we would like to head upstairs and bring the party to them.
We got a live one.
So there's some medical supplies and a little bit of a medical center up here, because this is, or was, a hospital. Like some upper floors have collapsed, and there are even, oh, they've been going after the railroad here. Oh, it's not that they had a particular interest in the railroad. They just wanted this space, presumably, because these are just ordinary raiders. Unless the railroad has a bad reputation from people who really, really are anti-synth. It seems plausible. Okay, so the way forward is not up here. Looks like it's straight ahead. Oh, there's an elevator here. That's what's going on. Something else knows that knew that we're here, but they've given up on finding us. This seems plausibly like a raider camp. You have the knives, you have bottle caps, you have this kind of lit desk and lit cigarette, which probably isn't going to stay lit. Probably a decent way to make a living. And it looks like they've done at least some of the right things with barricades. Keeping weapons on hand. Decent sleeping quarters. Now, this is unsanitary. Apart from being really disgusting, there's no reason there might be some psychological reasons that they would want to do that, but in general, it's not a good idea. And here we have the actual main area. The quieter we can do this, the better equipped we'll be. I might prefer just to see if we can get this guy's head off and go, because he has a rocket launcher, and it could be quite unpleasant.
No need to hide. I know you're here.
Pressing forward.
I'll find you.
Largely, I was worried about being hit with a rocket. But I think we killed the guy who had the rocket, which should make this relatively safe.
Come on out.
Dangerous.
I'll
to
make
go
it
out on
nice
like
and
this.
Quick.
By
you can trust me.
I'm stupid. But my character is apparently phenomenal at stealth with the perks that I've taken, so the extent that that works like a superpower rather than just having exceptionally good judgment like it probably would in the real world.
Yes.
We'll use it. I can't.
When you
One more down.
Looks like there's a dog nearby. Nope. Whoa. Hey, dog. Whoa. Sorry, dog. So this used to be a railroad safe house. That's pretty cool. Clearly they did not have enough people around to keep it safe.
That's it.
But it looks like they would have a lot of the stuff that they would need to live well. Probably an interesting story as to how they lost it.
Fucking pay for that.
Okay, and someone downstairs. And another person. Good. Yeah. It's a shame that they lost this safe house. This actually would have been a nice headquarters. Maybe it isn't in the right part of the Commonwealth. It might be a little too dangerous around here to want to have synths and other operatives moving in and out, but generally speaking, this place is awesome. Anyhow. You know what direction we want to move in. Not quite sure how to do it. Oh, hello. That is not good. That is not a sound or a sight you want to do. Just a regular death bomb. I think we can take it pretty easily. We've faced much more advanced cousins of it in the
past. Don't let it get close. Pop a stealth boy if you got one.
Where is he? He is down there. Or she. Not exactly easy to tell with wizards. Actually in here. Yeah, so that is definitely a shortcoming with this place, and that if you somehow don't notice a death bomb, or if you do notice but decide to be here anyhow, it's pretty bad judgment. And unless the raiders somehow learn to control death bombs, seems a little bit unlikely. Then this would be a pretty bad place. Maybe, although it's kind of hard to imagine how the Deathclaw got into here in the first place. Occasionally in the game, they've hinted that Deathclaws might be able to do it. So maybe that's a plausible story here. Some radots. We know that we're going to be in the radiated area. That's good stuff. Even with the radots, we're taking this much. It's not a good thing. move in. So there's one more thing to do while we're out here. I'm going to set up this Mila thing. But first, how are we doing on weight? Not great, but not terribly. So let's head to Police Precinct 8. And it's a short hop north. Diamond City to have their guards be around occasionally. That's cool. That again means we have to be careful with our weapon use. It's kind of a cute little area. You could imagine if somebody were to be able to close off this entrance here, which is problematically large. And this could be a place for a cute little settlement.
Salvage. You'll break your back here.
Insert something Shakespearean involving the terrible
doom here. Okay, so we are asked to go inside here. Let's do it.
That was a good one. You have any more stories like that?
How much time you got? Yeah, I have a few. Let me see. A couple years back, before I met Clutch, me and a couple friends found a young kid on the north side of the Charles. He wasn't that young, probably around 18 or so. Anyway, after hanging out with him for a while, it started to get dark, so I built a fire. I kid you not. As soon as I lit the first match, the kid screams, "What are you doing?" and knocks the match out of my hand.
He knocked the match out of your hand? Why did he do that?
Shh! I'm telling a story. So, yeah, he knocks the match out of my hand. I was so surprised that I swung and broke his nose. He said he was sorry. And get this. He said he was afraid of fire.
Oh, man. He was afraid of fire?
I just told you he was afraid of fire. You keep interrupting me. It's irritating. As soon as he told me that, I thought of something. I quickly apologized for hitting him and told him it's nothing to be ashamed of. That night, me and the others got this kid so drunk so fast, he passed out within an hour. We then dragged him to the banks of the Charles. We also dragged 6 or 7 mattresses and tied them in a circle with one in the middle.
Mattresses? What did you need the mattresses for?
Really? Did you seriously just ask me that question? It's a goddamn story. All you have to do is listen. So yeah, we tied all these mattresses together, And then we placed one mattress in the middle and put the kid on it. We doused all the mattresses with gas, except his, and then lit them on fire and pushed them down into the water. We followed the burning mattresses down the river, laughing our asses off, waiting for the kid to wake up. After 5 minutes, we realized the kid wasn't going to wake up, so we all started throwing rocks at him. After a couple of hits, the kid's awake. At this point, the flames were huge. Imagine what it must have been like for him, waking up, not knowing where he was, and all he sees is fire. The kid tries to stand up, but can't get his footing on the soggy mattress. At this point, I'm laughing so hard I fall down.
That is crazy! I bet he overcame his fear of fire. Huh? Trial by fire?
Nah, he never did. Turns out the kid couldn't swim. Anyway, that's that.
Didn't see that coming.
That is... It's a mean story, but a very funny story. Hey, guys. Catch. That occasionally happens. Occasionally, raiders have these great, funny stories that are often pretty mean.
Drop dead already!
So our goal here is to
play engage with me, huh?
Scared, huh? Should be.
Ah!
Why don't you just die?
Ah!
Getting a good amount of ammo replenishment here, which is pretty nice. If I were a lot more fiddly, I'd be looking at this armor.
Disappearing
and
act.
Possibly.
Huh?
Seeing if there's a way that I can upgrade my companion armor. But I am pretty happy with this. This has a lot of options.
Seems we have a tail.
Nothing!
We deserve to fight another day.
And night. And day. Etc., etc.
So one theory that I think makes a lot of sense in the game is that pre-war, people were a lot tougher. And somehow the radiation...
I've done this hundreds of times!
...that's limited the,
You might want to focus on the valuable salvage.
Which would kind of fit with why the Institute wanted to get you or your son as a basis for building synths. Because the genetic stock of humans, presumably after all of after the apocalypse, might be quite poor. Okay, near. Okay, so it's just a little bit northeast. Let's see. Further. Yeah. Okay. Maybe a little bit further. Further. Maybe a little less far. Okay, there we go.
Nice.
We're not quite at the stage where we need to worry about our weight obsessively, but we're getting there. And here we are, path to the roof. So another lock to pick.
Sweet.
Always good to get more adhesive. Up we go. This is where we're gonna put Mila. Okay. So next step is back to the railroad and to see if that was enough. Let us make the ghoul armor. Might not be. Probably won't be. But it's good to get the first round of quests done.
Hey, you.
Yes, do you have a quest for me?
Excuse me.
Hey, you. Randolph's safe house has been MIA. Des wants you to check.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
I hope this means right.
It'd be nice to get... Once you take care...
Okay, so that's... the quest.
Ah, it's our newest agent.
Augusta's safe house was destroyed by the Institute.
It's as I feared. Three safe houses. I have nothing further for you at the moment.
Okay, so that's Carrington.
Things are quiet.
God damn it. Losing Augusta is a real blow.
Hey, you. You the new heavy?
Not your fault, I know.
Professor, right?
In the flesh.
Likewise.
Mm-hmm.
So the switchboard was...
I didn't do it alone.
That's hardcore. How'd you take down the old HQ?
Mm-hmm. There's a lot to be said for him.
No. Well, welcome to the party.
Thanks for inviting.
We should... They call me Glory.
Kind of a mouthful.
You can call me Miss Angel. You're helping out my people. So some advice?
Duly noted.
You take care out there.
Glory.
Would it kill them to let me know mission specs before the dead drop? Just
Desdemona.
Once?
Good work on Augusta. I'd rather know the hard truth than live in ignorance. Working with compartmentalized information is a difficult transition for new agents.
Neil is transmitting loads of information. At first glance, I already lined up another...
Okay. There's that.
Hey there.
I was power napping and whammo, it hit me! Got some idea?
Right.
Make your super...
Uh-huh. I'll take a look.
I will set you up, my friend.
Okay, so he doesn't sell the nicer stuff yet, which is probably a sign that I can't make it yet. I might be able to sell him some of my other stuff that I don't need. It's not useful. That's not useful, and it's just way too heavy. That's definitely not useful. Okay.
Bet you never met a synth before Glory.
And we'll go talk.
Glad you're with us.
Our robot friend.
Setting human machine interface to 100%. Good day, agent. My data indicates I have the location of a Black Ops cache. It contains Railroad Alpha, has asked for
pre-war cache.
Unable to process. The cache is hidden in compliance.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Correct. The cache below. You only have to secure the...
So this quest here is kind of stupid, I think. In that it just doesn't make sense that you could... All you'd have to do is go somewhere and open a door and then somebody else
Deacon's record is the
up.
Best. You could learn a lot from him. Establishing Mercer Safe House is a sign we're on the road to recovery.
And the Thank railroad can control the timing.
For every Tom. Synth that makes it out?
The boys have been working on some new toys. You want to take a look?
Let's take a look.
I will set you up, my friend.
Yeah. None of the new stuff. Okay. So. I think we're going to cut this video off here, and we'll have a second stage of quests that we'll do.
I'm very busy.
That we'll do in a future video.
Unless you need my medical expertise, please bother someone else.
So that will be all. I'll see you in a future video where hopefully we'll progress further towards actually having some decent armor on this character. Bye bye.